What's up, friends? What's up? Come back. Back to my humble stream. Set up to go to the next mission. Gonna fight some bad guys here, the gangsters. They're holding control of the territorial control of that place where we have the jacking point for the Matrix. The Apex AI backdoor. Apparently they have some stash here, some medical supplies and equipment. We're gonna go ahead and talk to this big guy here. But we're gonna have to kill everybody here. And be able to walk our way into the place. Huge York in red combat fatigues. Steps forward to meet you. He walks with the swollen bravado of a man who's used to getting what he wants. One of his meaty arms jerks up and held upright in universal sign for stop. The other clutches a bulky assault rifle. Damn, look at those teeth. You get those teeth, bro. Dark inspects you. His body language is decidedly unfriendly. Oh. That's where they get him from. You're an arc. It's your race. Your race features. You don't look like a magnifier. Magnifier. Not one of us, and I'm guessing you ain't here for the hub either. So tell me, who are you? What's your interest in this building? Business can discuss it. Stand. Get in the basement. Hey, stand up before getting hurt. I'm here. Actually, I'm here for the hub. We did kind of gear? Bullshit. If you're here for the hub, then I'm cross dressing off. He grins, revealing a mouth filled with jagged teeth. This building is under arbiter protection. Can't let anyone by who's packing that kind of heat. You don't want the building getting shot up after all. Looks pretty shot up already. A few more holes couldn't hurt. It all depends on where you put him. Look, pal, it'd be better for everyone if you just turn back. We don't want to fight you. But we can risk letting an unknown player into this. Pauses for a moment to search for the right word. Into this situation right now. You don't get to make the call. It's inside and that's where I'm going. You wanna try to stop me? Maybe I could help you with your situation. Well, that puts it a different spin off of things. Pauses for a moment to consider. You look like you can handle yourself. We could probably use you if you're willing to help. There'd even be some money in it for you, but if not, well, saw rifle in his hand shifts positions. That's a different conversation. But if not, well, that's a different. And what exactly do you want us to do? Your stone is neutral and posture excellent. But one of her hands casually comes to rest on the butt of her shotgun. Rich doesn't seem to notice. We're having some trouble with a local mage gang, the Magnifiers. Dorf turns his head and spits. They attacked us without warning, took up in our building and kicked us onto the street. Me and my boys, we're the rightful protectors of this block, but the assholes that screwed us, they've got the building buttoned up pretty tight. Can't get in there to make things right, but maybe you can. We could enter the building and do some damage to those drag-eating magnifiers. The arbiters would be willing to pay you. 200 million per kill. Bring me back their amulets, and you get paid. How's that sound? Don't sound so bad. Nigga raises an up. Your call, fearless leader. You know what the timetable we're working on. Your head in bed, but from what I'm standing, it looks like you need my help. Can't tell me you can do that. So they are rich. I don't have charisma to bargain. Deal so. Good, yeah. I think that this will work. Billy gives you a small nod, her hand falls away from the stock of her shotgun. Need anything else? Or are you ready to go crack some skulls? No, I'm working for. No. What I'm going up against don't work. Just one more thing. I need to get into the basement. Anything you can do that help me out? Basement. What could you possibly want to go down there for? You wouldn't believe me if I told you. I need to get in. I just need to get in. Can you get me in or what? Or not? Yeah, I can help you, but it's busted. You're charging us? Seriously? This isn't even your building anymore. You got the wrong idea. I don't need Nguyen, friend. What I need is 3 Damio's head on a fucking platter. Problem is, he's holed up somewhere in the building, and we don't know where. Best guess, he's hiding somewhere upstairs, in a room with no exterior windows. Somewhere, probably someplace close, he stashed the power coupling from the elevator. He pulled it to keep us from getting access to the guns we stashed in the basement. So you find and kill Tritemius, grab the coupling out of his apartment, bring me that stupid amulet he's always wearing so I'll know he's dead. He could just talk him into giving that shit and the amulet, and he wouldn't be dead and you wouldn't know. He cracks a grin. Then I give you the control chip that I pulled when we had to fall back. Slot them both back into the elevator and I'll take you straight to the basement. It'll take you straight to the basement. Then I give you the control chip that I pulled when we had to fall back. Slot them back. Then both back into the elevator. I'm gonna play fair with this guy, seems like a reasonable guy. Right, I see what I can do. Good. Just remember, no amulet, no bait. Now, go on through. And show that little prick what it means to screw up with the arbiters. Give the fuck off about the arbiters or the other ones. Anyway. I want to know what I'm looking for. They're of the Berlin chapter of the Arbiters. They're called the club, small but growing. Help the people of the working class, protect them from parasites that bite them. Not a friend of the F-State. Then, anarchy is not the solution to the people's problems. No. The policy that rewards only the powerful. Working class gets ramped. Strong people send a communist movement. The only way to protect the interests of the common man. That's like where we're gonna be. I want to know what I'm going up against. Tell me about the Magnificers. Gang of parasites, they think that their magical talents make them better than everyone else. Because of that, they feel entitled to take whatever they want. Up until recently, they've been contests with pulling ranks and stealing purses. Childish wreck. But they were basically harmless. Then their new leader took over, calls himself Treat Demuse. But I remember when he was just a skinny little prick named Yuri. That's not a busy smart. I should've kept a better eye on him, I guess. Should've stomped him flat when he started putting more on the hairs. Would've saved everyone a heap of trouble. Demius took over the Magnificers, militarized them and convinced them they could take us, and thanks to that, I'm not surprised they actually managed to do it. Holds his arms across his chest. And then now we're gonna show him exactly how bad an idea that was. I think I'll start by breaking Yuri's neck. You look pretty much dug out in here, and how long do you intend to man the trenches? We'll be out here as long as it takes. We're taking our building back one way or another. For over 3 years we protected that place. We held it for the people to do as they please. Getting safe from parasites and exploiters. Everything was cool until those dregs saw Magnificers sucker punched us. No negotiation, no warning. They just turned on us out of the blue. Brought a couple dozen spirits down our heads. I didn't even know that we were under attack until the water in my bathtub snaked up and tried to drown me. Most of us got out alive, but we've been stuck out here ever since. Just give us some time though. We'll take the building back. We'll starve them out if we have to. And when we do, those county bastards are gonna pay. Anything I should know about the building before I head inside? You'll probably see some burnouts floating around the ground floor. They're all there for the, it's like some kind of church or some guy called person runs. Between you and me, they're all batshit crazy. Not dangerous, just nuts. Why do you keep them around at all then? Because a lot of them are rich, they paid a drag load in rent. And we would redistribute that wealth to the common man. Shit. me guess, you define yourself as the common man. Do you see a tie around my neck, pal? Do I look like a corporate stooge to you? We are the friends of the people, and we are the people. Don't you dare to question it. That's it. Behind the counter is an uncommonly fine featured dwarf. Yet, typical smile, yellow ID tag into his chest announces his name in large blocky letters. Parse. Now that you have raised his hand. Great. Welcome to the hub, sister. Are you here to share in the splendor of the community? So I can show you an empty term. What do you do here? I might be interested. Tell me more. What do you do here? The custodian of the hub. Attend to the bodies of our brothers and while they share the rapture of. Like some rigid. Cults they have going on here. I have some questions for you about the logo. Okay. Not. We do seem to have more than our fair share. Very well. I will answer your questions. Where about the gang? It seems. You have nothing to fear. We pay well for the use of this place. And neither gang is driving us away. And the rest of the building. We spread his hands. If you choose to go exploring, I can guarantee you safety. And tell me about their beaters. Pack of snarling animals dressed up as a poly club. I'd still fear of them if I were you. Their ideology is loosely based on neo-communist movements from the past. In truth, I think that they just copied a few pages from an old red army faction handbill without ever bothering to learn what they meant. For all their rhetoric, arbiters are just another street game. They shout for the sake of shouting. There's no real conviction there. You came from outside, you probably bumped into their leader, a huge orc who calls himself Ulrich. Can seem reasonable, but I'd give him a wide berth. So I'm gonna have to kill those mages. I might as well get paid for it. Then kill those guys too if I need to. Those communist gangsters. One more note, if I were you, I'd avoid being seen with the magnifiers. Arbiters take shots at members of the mage gang, whatever they... them. If you're not careful, you could find yourself caught in the crossfire. I'm looking forward to Damius. Any idea how I could find him? Smile fades from a person's face. Damage is a dangerous man. Why do you ask? My deal with Woolrich, Damage is involved. Rich asked me to kill him. I didn't have much care. Bad idea, so I got control. My deal with Woolrich, Damage is involved. Damage is almost certainly upstairs, hidden away from the outside world. I wouldn't advise going after him, but if your mind is made up, I suppose that I can change it. Yes, I can tell you how to find him, but I will need something from you in return. Of course you will. Know that coming. Tell us all you need. A pair of squatters on the second floor ripped the guts out of one of my terminals. They have taken the data jacks on the converter, and the terminal will be out of commission until I get it back. Single damage terminal may not sound like much, but trust me. Entire experience of communion been diminished by this act of vandalism. But I give a fuck about your communion, dude. I believe that I know the squatters responsible. Your leader's name is Janet. Squatters don't have leaders, dude. I think squatting is not a religious cult like that shit you have going on here. She's a decker of some skill. I don't know what she has planned for my parts, but I do know that this situation will not stand. I cannot allow another terminal to be damaged. So you want us to deal with them for you? Yes, but not with violence. I want you to talk with them, convince them to bring back my components. Do this and I'll tell you how to get to Damius. Deal? Sounds straightforward enough. No better idea. Why don't you just tell me? I want to know now, and then there won't be any need for violence. I have a better idea. Why don't you just tell me what I want to know now, and there won't be any violence. I cannot accept this diminishment of the community. I believe you were meant to bring us back together, and it will be so. I need that information, and I need it now. Unless you want to see some real violence, tell me what I want now. Chuckles softly to himself. Killing me will only allow me to join forever with the community. And you will have destroyed the only source of information you require. Get me my parts, and you'll have your information. Alright. I'll see what I can do. I have to go talk to my squatter brothers. Give this jump. Gear back. Excellent. It's a deal then. Interested? Tell me more. Tell me anything about this building. You know, up there isn't much to speak of. There's a small shop down the hall if you're hungry. Or in need of basic supplies, he shrugs. Jerry smile. That's about it, I'm afraid. What about the upper levels? I need down to the basement, thank you. What about the upper levels? There are floors above us, of course. But you're unlikely to find anything of value up there. Just the domiciles of the faithful. The magnificers who have taken charge of them. I would still clear of them if I were you. I need to get down to the basement. Ah, that would be difficult. The stairway leading down the building's sublevels has been blocked. And the elevator has been sabotaged. It stopped working at the same time that their biters are driven from the building. As we discussed, if you recover my stolen property, I will tell you how to find the three cameos. Otherwise, you could try your luck with your rich out of front. I wouldn't recommend it. Right again. Got both of those. You know what? I think maybe I'll do this later. Another game. Getting a bit boring right now. middle-aged woman, chocolate-colored skin, and shoulder-length dreadlocks, looks up from her PDA. Start. She's decked out in form-fit body armor, and in a flash, her assault rifle goes on at the ready. Bell, are you? And how did you get through the door? Use my charm and honor of Musk gets him every time. She gestures with the rifle. Cut the sheet and start talking. What do you want and why are you here? Well, so these guys are the squatters. Person sent me. He wants his hardware back. Shakes her head violently. No way. Those parts are keeping us online. And not just us, but everyone worth annoying in this hall. Barson can keep running his ridiculous little cult just fine. What he's got. But us, we're the only Matrix connection that these people have. Parts right now. I don't want to get this messy, so back down. Not gonna happen. She aims her rifle at you for him. Five, take a look at me. You know how the sense hardware can be replaced, but you can't. Armor in a little corner of the Matrix. No one needs to get it. She can react quick. It's five. Take a look at me. You know how this ends. Hardware can be replaced, but you can't. She looks you up and down, and you can see doubt running in her eyes. I don't know, sure, slumping defeat. She lowers her gun inside of the others in the room. Fine, you ain't asshole. Take terminals in the back room. Thanks for saying me that ammo. Good call. Right thing. Stay black. Screw you. Take your parts and get the hell out of my apartment. Sorry, bro. I didn't want to do this as well. That guy. That guy's got the information I need. You can get the parts later again. Terminal as clearly cobbled together whatever parts they could find. In spite of this, it's really remarkably impressive piece of machinery. Setting the terminal, it takes almost no time to identify the components that Parson sent you to find. Examine the terminal to see if the sign cord can be removed without the same. The moment it's impossible to remove the part, you know, the same with the terminal, the converter is required so that the signal a sense can be interpreted by the data jack off. A deck in artificial intelligence characters. I have my teammate examine the terminal to see if parts can be replaced. So I'm gonna find another part to leave this thing working for these guys. Converter is a pretty specialized piece of hardware, but a data jacking pulse transmitter is a widely available piece of equipment and could be converted to work in its place. So I gotta find this piece. Optional, find an impulse transmitter. Yeah, and then a good target brightness. Glad you enjoyed. Gonna have a blast. Can use the adrenal pump to run down the light to revive them. And I have a double light. Also. And that I shot on these fuckers. Okay. Cover. I can heal. Dress up, hombre. Better not fuck with me. Gonna taste the steel. Taste the lead. Come at me like this, bro. I'd be crazy. I'd be insane in the membrane. Check yourself before you wreck yourself. Bad boy. Run away. try something funny. This is good for deep breach. Target cannot move but can still use AP to attack. Just fanatic sleep. of metahumans huddles together, their eyes wide with terror. Many of them have scrapes and bruises, and a few have more serious injuries. Their clothes are tattered and stained. Their approach at his hell, a middle-aged man steps forward. Between you and the man group. Pain is bare, is badly made. A bedroom is the rage of his life. Why are you masked and what are you doing here? And you are nobody important in this man. Nobody important, just passing through. Who are you? My name is Friend, these are my friends and my wife. Live together. Well, we used to live up on the third floor. Used to live upstairs? Yes, until about a week ago, then magnifiers. That's we had to run lives. Spirits, you mean? Not a look of misery on his face. They're always summoning them things. But last week, they lost control of a handful. Before we knew what was happening, they were running wild in our living room. We tried to protect ourselves, but we were no match for them. He shakes his head, a haunted look in his eyes. We had no choice but to leave everything behind. We've been scraping down here. Collect himself. He speaks again. This Janet is letting us use our magic's uplink. We can still afford to feed ourselves thanks to her. Janet, I need to talk to her. Choose us. See Janet first. After her. Control spirits lose it in there, up there. Someone needs to do them. Might as well be us. Francis' face lights up with his helmet. Oh, thank you. Please let us know when it's safe to return home. Spirits are suites. Considering the state of the rest of the building, the stairwell looks. So what the fuck do I do? That's your AP. What do I need to do? Oh shit. Stupid fucker. Shit. But I get with the leg. Instead of picking the guy, I click the floor. Sometimes click on the side instead of clicking the guy. But in damage. gunfire up to those guys. Instead of pressing the guy, normally comments and I'm here. Check my ground.
Thank you.
big mana with all these amulets. I think it's like 2,200 cards for 200 a pop. It's a bit like 1,000 credits. Go away. I won't let you let any spirits in here. Can't hurt me behind my door. No, you can't. spits and claws at the air in front of you, as if fighting off an invisible attacker. All the while, his eyes are locked on you. No, it isn't safe. The spirits, not safe. Come down, there are no spirits, they're gone all the way. Empty, yes, empty. All is empty without community. One of those cultists, crazy cultists. Safe, you say. Safe. Let's go away. I can return to communion. Breaks into ridicule. Must go now. Yes, communion awaits. Those crazy communion guys. Fanatics. The guy downstairs gives us a transmitter when we handle the amulets, get paid. Maybe in the basement we can find it. To examine the control. Critically easily prized the metal casing away from the wall, causing a mess of wire. After a quick inspection, it becomes clear that this elevator is required to operate around the control chip. The chip is missing. It looks as though a power coupling has been yanked alongside it.